Yo, what up, social media? You thought we forgot, right? Lies and Lying Part 3, back at you.
Oh, you thought we forgot?
Done? I know some of y'all thought this was going to stop, but we back at it again. See, when someone says Dr. Malachi Z pled guilty and got 135 years, you know something is mentally wrong with them, and surgery is usually necessary. See, a plea is supposed to be a deal, a bargain, something that benefits the alleged criminal to influence them to accept the charges. If you really believe that Dr. Y'all took a plea of a life sentence,
then I feel sorry for your mother.
What you say about my
head high, holding my crown up. Ain't the only king when I rise up. Every brother I'm around got they mind up. No crabs over here, we done wised up.
Now, there's a string of weirdos on social media who's infatuated with Dr. York, who want to be leaders. What they do is perpetuate this nonsense that Dr. York has a stake to. Now, the fact is, Dr. York went to trial. So there is no plea, whether federal or state. Try to get that through your mind.
Malachi does not have a state plea. Let me repeat. Malachi does not have a state plea because the concession was that the state plea and the fed plea goes together. And when I pulled back on that bogus federal plea, the state plea went down with it. So there is no state plea. That's another hype, another lie that they put out there. That's when they tricked her with to make her think I got hundreds of years coming and all that kind of stuff. It's a big game. It's a reality. You follow? Now let's establish that the state and the fed case ran together. They ran it together because the fed used the state witnesses. So when the fed case falls, the state case has to fall at the same time. They can't pretend they got two different cases and it's the same witness. That's called a conflict of interest, and it's called double judges' conflict of interest already established by what you read. Uh-huh. Double jeopardy if they try to use the same people they used in the previous case, and most of them had already perjured themselves while they was on the stand.
So now, if you didn't already know, there are three types of pleas. There's a plea of guilty, there's a plea of not guilty, and finally, there's a no contest plea, which is a plea of guilty while still maintaining your innocence. In other words, a false guilty plea. Dr. York originally pled not guilty on May 9th of 2002 to all the charges. It was not until he was tortured into taking this false guilty plea that they made an illegal video that was circulated on social media to paint the picture of molestation.
And I think what most Americans think of, because they've watched so many courtroom dramas and things like that, they think that criminal justice system is about judges and juries. Well, that's really stopped being the case.
The system simply cannot exist if everyone decides to go to trial.
Everybody insisted on a trial, the whole system would shut down.
What typically happens is the prosecutor says, you know, you can make a deal and we'll give you 3 years, or you can go to trial and we'll get you 30. So you want to take that chance? Feel free.
Nobody in the hood goes to trial.
97% of those people who were locked up have plea bargain. And that is one of the worst violations of human rights that you can imagine in the United States.
We have in this country people pleading guilty to crimes they didn't commit just because the thought of going to jail for what the mandatory minimums are is so excruciating.
What you're not told is that if you exercise that right to a trial, and you are convicted, we will punish you more.
As you look at the video, you can see that Dr. York is under duress after being tortured. He's limping as if he's been batted. He's not even responding. Does he even know where he's at in this video? And I want the viewers to listen carefully as the now deceased district attorney, Frederick Bray, says he's withdrawing York's original plea of not guilty to guilty. I wonder why.
Your Honor, we've drawn up this withdrawal of not guilty plea and entered guilty plea.
What?
Your Honor, we've drawn up this withdrawal of not guilty plea and entered guilty plea.
What?
Your Honor, we've drawn up this withdrawal of not guilty plea and entered guilty plea.
Okay!
It's hard to accept this known fact, but it's true. In all seriousness. What fact? There is no plea. What do you mean? I just watched the video. I understand that, but let me explain. In a court proceeding, when someone is accused of something and that someone takes a plea, usually the case is over. That's an open and shut case. Pleas save tons of money for the court system. It's practically a money-saving machine or a piggy bank for the courts. But if that someone is going to trial, which costs money, for the same thing the plea bargain was drawn up for, that plea bargain is now null and void. Therefore, there's no more plea. It's simple mathematics.
There you have it. The average mindset of most people who watch this video ignorantly without no knowledge of the trial. Hence, this illegal video that the government leaked us for one purpose, and one purpose only, which was to declare Dr. York guilty by public opinion. Sadly, many people out there in the social media world actually believe it. And that only proved that many of you still trust the devil in their fake news.
Listen, this is a corrupt case. It's bogus. You know what I'm saying? I'm innocent of these charges. They know I am. I've written 407 books. I've scared a living heck out of these people because I'm so literate and on the growth of this organization. And then on top of that, I'll try.
In conclusion, number one, York always upheld his innocence from day one. Number two, York was under duress and tortured into taking a plea agreement for 15 years, which means that by now, he would have been free already. Number three, the same government rejected York's 15-year plea agreement. Isn't that something? And number four, York reaffirmed his innocence and goes to trial. And after a hung jury, he is still unjustly found guilty and sentenced to 135 years. Now, if that's not a conspiracy, I don't know what to tell you guys. Stay tuned for Lies of Liars Part 4. And don't forget to share, like, and subscribe. Thank you.